Finally, second round of overtime, and the Tampa Bay Lightning defeat the Boston Bruins in this Eastern Conference semifinals in just five games. This year's playoffs has been absolutely insane. Whichever team gets pretty much a 3-1 lead is guaranteed to win the series. That's been the case thus far until proven otherwise. Yeah. 2004 Tampa Bay Lightning Stanley Cup champions right there. Will it be in 2020? I don't know. And shout out to my brother. That's his banner. Little does he know that I took it and put it on my wall for this video. But wow, this is going to be such an awesome video. And if you're new here, my name's Tyler and I just do consistent content, all things related hockey in the NHL. And like I said, we will be discussing this amazing victory by the Tampa Bay Lightning, defeating the Boston Bruins, advancing to the Eastern Conference Finals. I believe this is the first time they will be back in the Conference Finals since beating the New York Rangers just a couple years ago. But that's what we'll be discussing in today's video. And if you are new here, make sure you do hit subscribe and like if you end up enjoying this kind of hockey content. Thank you all so much for everyone that's been following me thus far. But getting right into this video, Tampa had the X factor. And what was that X factor? It was depth scoring, something that Boston just honestly couldn't compete with throughout this entire series. As we all know, I believe Boston won the first game, but after that, it was all Tampa, and they did not skip a beat. Tampa Bay in the third game of the series, of course, winning 7-1. Kucherov had 4 points in that game, and Kuch, even though he did get hurt in this game, which I am worried about, I don't know the details on that. There was very controversial things that happened in this game five, especially with a lot of missed calls, but besides all that, I will get to that in a second. This Tampa team was just electric, and their depth scoring stood out. Andre Palat, this guy was insane. Braden Point looking great as always, and then Victor Hedman looking very solid as he normally does. One of, if not the best defenseman in the NHL. And Andre Vasilevsky hushing all the doubters that say don't like his contract, whatever it may be. He's proving his worth right now, and what an impressive victory by the Tampa Bay Lightning this was against a Boston Bruins team that went all the way to the Stanley Cup last year, looking like they were going to have another deep run this year. That is not the case. Tampa Bay is proving their doubters wrong after being swept by Columbus last year. That is, of course, in the past. This is the present. Wow, this was an insane series. Hats off to you, all you Tampa Bay Lightning fans. You deserve it, because this was something that a lot of people doubted going into this year. You know, Tampa was kind of up and down times this year, not knowing how to feel. Nikita Kucherov got overshadowed given the fact that he didn't have as good of a season as he did last year, even though he still had an amazing season, and he really stood out in this year's playoffs thus far, even though he is now hurt. If you do find out the details on it, let me know in the comments below. But getting into the series, Tampa Bay outscored Boston in this series, which was ridiculous, 19-10. Like, are you kidding me? That is absolutely insane. Their depth scoring, as I said, was just otherworldly in this series, given the acquisitions like the Pat Maroons, the Barkley Goudreaus, and of course the Blake Colemans of the world. People doubting those moves at first, that is paying off in dividends for this team that on paper has the best roster in the NHL and has for a while now. But having Coleman step up, Goudreau step up, Palat look amazing, Yanni Gord, Tyler Johnson still looking solid, this whole team has just been amazing overall. And then when you get into their points, Braden Point led the way with 17 points in this year's playoffs as far, including 6 points in these five games against the Bees. And then you get Kucherov with 16 points, had 7 points in these five games. And then Andre Palat, amazing playoff this far with 9 points and 5 points in this series. Amazing. And then you get on to, of course, the Boston Bruins. David Krejci, who is one of the best and most overlooked players when it comes to playoffs. He's an unsung hero for them. If you look up his playoff statistics, they are ridiculous. It doesn't matter what this guy does in the season, the playoffs, he is just on another level. And who knows what his future will hold, because I'm not sure if it'll be with Boston going forward, because I do believe his contract is up. I could be wrong. If I am, let me know in the comments below. But David Krejci had 12 points in this series, including three. He had 3 in this series and 12 points in the playoffs overall. Brad Marchand had 12 points and 5 in this series, really looking strong. And then Pasta had 10 points and 6 of them came in the series. Pasta was dealing with injuries earlier going into this year's playoffs, but he really looks strong. Only had 2 goals though in this entire playoff, which is a little shocking, but at the end of the day, Boston just couldn't get it done. And it is surprising, honestly. This team, obviously the best defensively in the NHL this past season, and having the best line in the NHL led by the likes of course, Brad Marchand, Patrice Bergeron, and Pasta. David Pastrnak, the best goal scorer in the NHL this past season. But they really were looking like a one-line team at times out there, and that was evident in this series again. So I'm not sure what the future is going to hold for this Boston Bruins team, but they still have a core group. Their goaltending, you know, that was very unfortunate with Tuukka Rask, but I do believe it was because something happened with his newly born daughter. I believe she's only a couple months old, if not a couple weeks. So I think that led to him leaving originally, because a lot of people were upset at first, including myself, but that obviously got put away once we found out the details. And then Halak played solid. Halak has always been a grizzled guy that gets a job done for you during the season. I can tell you as a Rangers fan, he's done great against them throughout his entire career. In the playoffs, he looked solid, but Tampa's scoring was just, it was ridiculous. Victor Hedman as well gained the game winner tonight, really off a smart shot with plenty of screens in front. This was just such an insane series. But let's talk about that hit. Let's talk about some of the hits and things that weren't called, right? That boarding call earlier in the game on Charlie McAvoy, that wasn't called. That was surprising. Whether you think that's boarding or not is completely up to you. You know, I'm going to leave you in the comments below to figure that out, especially if you're a Tampa fan. You're probably more against it being a boarding than for, obviously, for biasly reasons. But regardless, that was such an odd no call, and there are plenty of other no calls. Braden Point and overtime, I believe, or towards the end of the third period, there was a clear call that should happen that didn't. He was furious about that, and rightfully so. Was it a slashing call? I thought his stick got broken. He was furious. But there was a lot of missed calls in this game. But what a game this was. The Boston Bruins came out full storm, of course, almost doubling the shots for the entirety of the game against the Tampa Bay Lightning team. Finished the game with just under 50 shots, I believe, in Tampa Bay. Still looks strong, still got the right shots on net, but this depth scoring, like I said, was just ridiculous. Anthony Cirelli, another one who's just been fantastic in all year's playoffs, and now the Tampa Bay Lightning go to the Eastern Conference Finals, which very well could be against the New York Islanders. What a series that would be. An offensive dynamo in the Tampa Bay Lightning and a defensive guru in the New York Islanders that are so hound on the puck. That would be quite the series to watch. But look, given the fact that the Tampa Bay Lightning did so good against a team that is so known for the defensive play and forechecking like the Boston Bruins, huge hats off to them. This was not an easy series at all, and they made it look easy for the most part. So regardless of having Rask in net or not, I don't think anything changes here. I think Tampa still wins this series because they were without question the better team. Their overall team play was great, and John Cooper is making everyone hush up, all the doubters, same thing. I thought going into this year, if Tampa Bay didn't have a deep run, then Cooper needs to be out because some things need to be changed. But he's clearly proving me wrong here, and hats off to him. Hats off to this Tampa Bay Lightning team. They deserve it. The fans deserve it. What a series this was. Let me know in the comments below, how hyped are you, Tampa Bay Lightning fans, to be going back to the Eastern Conference Finals in a couple years now? You know, you've had your deep playoff runs, but now you're back. You're looking serious. Well, little expectations this year. I think you guys are really overcoming something. So we'll not surprise me at all to see you back in the Stanley Cup final shortly. But that's all for this video. Let me know what you think in the comments below, whether you're a Tampa Bay Lightning fan, Boston Bruins fan, whomever. Make sure to let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear it. And if you haven't checked out my previous videos, make sure you do. I'll have them right down here below. If you aren't new here and you've been following me, then you know my setup for my channel is completely different. I hope you enjoy it. A lot of great things are happening on this channel. New equipment, new setup, new lighting, all that stuff. And this is only the beginning, guys. Things are going to get so much better. So make sure you check out my previous playoff videos, and I'll be having videos for summer summarizing each series in this year's playoffs, as I have been doing thus far. And make sure to stay tuned if Dallas comes back tonight, which I doubt, but if they do, I will have a video for that as well. So make sure to stay tuned. But thank you all again, guys. I really appreciate it, and I'll be back in a day or two.